Once upon a time, there was a computer. It was the greatest computer ever created because it was perfect. Thanks to the knowledge and enthusiasm of many brilliant people, there's a good chance we'll be able to enjoy its potential once more and bring it back to life, to keep it with us forever. Here is Pimmodore 2.0, an Amiga emulator.
Here we have three storage devices with different read and write speeds, but all with the same capacity. A Samsung, a 128GB M2 Kingston, and a USB drive with a 5-year warranty, which has pretty good specs for a USB device. We've installed Pimmodore 2.0 on this last one. We'll now connect it to the USB port on the desktop computer and see what happens. We select the drive we want to boot the computer from. There are plenty of options and a few drives to choose from.
At first glance, it's clear that it's starting up much faster than the previous version. This is the first boot, so let's start by checking the README file. It's necessary to set up an internet connection to install free third-party software from developers who don't want their software sold. Let's first see what's available. It turns out there are only two systems ready for expansion and installation. So perhaps this will finally satisfy those who had reservations about making this project accessible. So now some programs that were available right away are missing. To install them, we need to click the little devil icon. We click the little devil, and the system asks if we want to use free third-party software. We click yes. I see something has changed. New icons have appeared on the desktop. I'll tidy things up a bit to make everything more organized. All right, according to the instructions in the README file, let's move forward. We select the boot selector and set up my favorite system, Coffin OS. We click OK, and now the Amiga should boot correctly. We restart. Select the drive again. And we're in. The Amiga is up and running. I'm recording this from Linux, so the stats are slightly lower normally. It runs much faster. We have all the classic Amiga games and demos here, as always. In addition, there are Linux games and emulators for other systems available. A new feature is the emulation console, which includes MAME games. Nintendo 64, and an option to add your own ROMs. The creator of Pimmodore is working on a program that will allow files to be added automatically. And we've got our Commodore 64 and VIC-20, complete with full libraries of games and programs. One could spend hours showcasing the capabilities of Pimmodore 2.0, but my goal was only to shed light on its basics. I'm sure there's something here for everyone. Once installed on a hard drive, this system can serve as the main operating system on your computer.